today we are reflow soldering some LED hearts. We have our bare circuit boards, we have our stencil, our solder paste, and over there there is a griddle, which is what is going to do the actual soldering. So step one is to align the stencil on the circuit board. Basically a matter of moving it until you can see silver through all the little holes and not white solder mask. So we got that about right. Actually, that was step two. Step one is take the top off the solder paste syringe and squirt the whole lot all over the stencil. It's probably enough for multiple boards, so fingers crossed. So we do our alignment. Once I'm satisfied that I got it in the right spot, out comes the solder paste spreader, and basically wipe it back and forward until everything looks suitably grey and not nearly as shiny as it was before. Once we're satisfied with that, we scrape off the excess. Try not to make too much of a mess, lift off the stencil, and now we have a circuit board covered in solder paste, which, as you can see, is significantly less shiny and hopefully will stick to components. Time to do the second board. Once again, we align the stencil. Okay, once again, we screw up the stencil alignment and try again, and we have it. And now I just take the paste that's already on the spreader, respread, wipe it around a bit, pick up some of the excess, wipe it around a bit more, and it looks like we're done. So peel off the stencil, and now we're ready to pick in place.
Now we have solder paste on our blocks, the next step is to get all the components on.
So conveniently, the solder paste is a little bit sticky, so when we drop components on, they'll kind of stay where they are. It's not like putting components on a bare board. So in this case, I've done this a few times before, and so I know which way up they go, but make sure you're putting them the right way around, and you just get your tweezers and place your components one by one. Try and get them as centered as possible, although surface tension will pull them closer to where they're meant to be during the soldering process. I've found with these, it's not perfect. So taking care the first time is definitely worthwhile. In this case, due to me wanting to route everything on the top side of the circuit board, these LEDs alternate orientation. We have a row facing up and then a row facing down. I've mostly placed all the LEDs here. You can see we have four more to go. And so here we go, finishing the second board. So I just opened a second reel of LEDs and found that these ones are slightly different to the first batch. So I'm not sure if you can see the difference in coloration there. I think the new ones start here. So this very interesting to see if this board works well or if like one row of LEDs is slightly brighter or dimmer than the other ones. So fingers crossed. Alright, and that's our last LED, which means it's time to get them on the grid.
Conveniently I've got a few holes on the side of the board, so I can pick the board up with my tweezers and place it on the grid.
Ready for baking.
Using some low temperature lead-free solder paste here, which means that I believe the solder melts at 137 Celsius. What I've found is if I set the griddle to its 250 Fahrenheit setting, it works out just about perfectly.
And the element is located near the edges of the griddle, so I usually put them out here So now it probably spends about a minute or so getting up to temperature. After it's been doing it for a little while, you'll see the solder paste start to dry out a little and also pool. I'm starting to see it over here. You can just about see it on these ones. You see the paste is spreading out. That happens pretty early, and we'll spend a lot of time watching it just sit there, and then suddenly we'll start to see a few of the joints pop and go all silvery, which means that they're soldered. It looks like I didn't put as much solder paste on the second board, but I trust that it'll work anyway. Something's going on. These ones are starting to solder over here. These ones are not at all. This one's pretty close to being done. Ooh, and I'm starting to see some joints soldering here. We're about halfway through. The ones right on that end are not... yep, they're just going now. Okay. I would say that this one's pretty much finished. We're starting to see some smoke coming off. That is both a good and a bad sign. Now's the chance to make any last minute placement corrections, but this one's looking pretty good. I will check this one. And I think we are good. So I'm going to turn this back to off. That's looking nice. Here we have two pretty nice looking boards. That was the front side of the front layer of the board, the top layer of the board, and we still have quite a few components left to go. However, because I don't feel like gluing components on and reflowing them in an oven, I'm stuck doing this by hand.